first is that, you know, when you take a look at the gospel, no, the real thing that I invite you to reflect on is how people were not really following, were not really concerned about data or facts. No? As I said, and this is the second point, initially they were astonished. No? But after a while, the biases set in. No? And their initial reaction, they just set aside, no, because of bias. No? So these two, the first two points that I invite you to reflect on. No? Do we follow what is the truth, what confronts us, what is, you might say, the phenomenon in front of us, or do we allow our biases to take over? No? So for me, that's something I think very important for us to reflect on and realize. And I think sometimes I sense myself doing that. No, at first you like what you see, you like what happened, and then eventually when you realize it's linked to someone you do not like, diba? There's that certain amount of bias also in each and every one of us, no? Myself included. No, and perhaps these first two points we must reflect on them together. No. The whole idea of do we follow, do we stick to the facts, or do we allow our biases to take over? No, and to realize that the initial reaction of the people to the phenomenon is one of astonishment, and even they said, "Where did this person get his wisdom?" No, so you realize that their actual experience makes them feel that this man is a man of wisdom. No, but eventually the biases kick in. No. And forget the facts, no? And what was the bias, no? Is he not one of us, etc.? Isn't he our neighbor? As we say, no? As the Lord himself says, no prophet is accepted in his own native place, no? Or as we would say now, familiarity breeds contempt, no? And that brings us to the last point, no? It's very interesting, and for me this is the main point that I invite you to reflect on, no? That the gospel tells us, and the Lord could not work any miracles there, because of their lack of faith. And for me, again, we go back, no? We go back to what we constantly reflected on in the past, no? That grace is always available, but we must ask for it, we must want it, we must desire it for it to have an effect in our lives, no? And here that is a very clear point here that the gospel tells us, no? The Lord could only cure a few sick people by laying hands on them. He was amazed at their lack of faith. He could not perform any miracles there because of their lack of faith. And for me, that is something that I think we must all really reflect on. No? Because sometimes we have that attitude, we have that impression, no, that God's miracle is like magic. No, we pray for it and we pray that the miracle will happen. No, but again, remember, it requires faith. And faith requires a certain amount of the Tagalog word is very, very spot on, no? Pananampalataya. There must be an investment that we will make, no? There must be an investment that we will make, no? And I think I shared with you the day after or 2 days after the Thanksgiving Mass of the movie Rewind, no? Now it has surpassed all records, no? Both internationally and locally. It's the highest grossing film of all time, no? And the movie was made with a lot of trust, no? They were planning it right before the pandemic, hindi natuloy because of the pandemic. And then around, I think, 2 years into the pandemic, they said, maybe we should start it. And at that time, Ding Dong and Marian were not available. So they said, you can go ahead, no? But then again, one thing led to another. It was postponed until finally it was made for the last Metro Manila Film Festival, no? But in all the process, in all the stories, no, that were shared during the Thanksgiving night, the theme that was just going was that was in a sense present in all the thank you speeches was trust, no, how much they trusted the story, the director, etc. But ultimately, trusting God's perfect timing, no, and then for me, that's an example of how someone open to faith allows grace to flow. No? Again, grace is not magic. No, grace is needs our cooperation also, and the cooperation needs faith and trust. No, siguro mahalaga na pag nilaya natin to, kasi nga itong ebanghelyon to napaka-familiar sa atin itong ebanghelyon to, di ba? Pero una, yung dalawang punto nga sinasabi natin na yung mga tao nagpadaig sa kanilang mga ano, ng mga hakahaka, no, mga marites, di ba? Pero ang mahalaga ay ano ba yung nasa harap natin? Ano yung katotohanan na nasa harap natin? So ito yung unang makikita natin, yung pagtutunggali ng nakita nilang katotohanan at ito'y naimpluwensyahan ng kanilang mga haka-haka, ano? At nakita natin yung unang reaksyon nila ay namangha sila, no, sa galing ng Panginoon. Pero nung pumasok yung kanilang mga haka-haka, yun, nagbago ng lahat, ano? At makita natin na ang pagtitiwala, ang pananampalataya ay kinakailangan ng pagrespeto sa kaano ang nasa harap natin, ano? Kaya nga sabi ng Ebanghelyo, hindi nakapaggawa ng milagro ang Panginoon, hindi siya nakapaghilom ng mga tao dahil sa kakulangan ng kanilang pagtitiwala at pananampalataya. At yan ang isang napakagandang masasabi natin katangian ng pagmamahal at ng biyaya ng Diyos sa atin. Na hindi ito pinapataw lang sa atin, pero kailangan natin hingin, kailangan natin buksan ang ating mga puso sa biyaya ng Diyos, no? Kailanman hindi niya ito ipipilit sa atin. So today let us pray, no, that we may renew our sense of trust and faith in God. Again, to cooperate with grace, no, to cooperate with God's movements in our life. And let us pray that the Lord may grant us this faith, no, this trust in His providence.